Hello and welcome to today's video. My name is Anniken. I design knitting patterns. I teach knitting workshops both online and in person, and I sell pretty yarns which are up there, which are hidden behind this sweater. So welcome to today's video. Thank you very much for joining me. Whether you're new here or a returning viewer, I really appreciate your time, so thank you very much for joining me. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. Giving the video a thumbs up and subscribing really helps me to build this channel, and it doesn't cost you anything. So I really appreciate, if you haven't subscribed yet, if you would subscribe. I release videos every single week, sometimes twice a week, and I do a combination of a podcast where I share what I'm doing, what I'm knitting, any yarn purchases, anything that's coming up, going on. Loads of different things, a bit of days out in Cornwall and wherever I happen to be at the time. I also release product reviews, yarn and knitting product reviews, and I talk about designs that I have in magazines. And that's what we're going to talk about today. So this is my design for Knitting Magazine. This is issue 235, which is in the shops in the UK now. It's been in the shops for about a week or so, I think. I'm not 100% sure when I'm going to release this video, so it's only been like a week or 10 days. So that is the cover. Love that sweater on the cover. It's very, very pretty. So today I'm going to tell you about this sweater specifically, and then also a little bit about the yarn. This is knitted in John Arbon Knit by Numbers DK. I'll talk more about the yarn and John Arbon company specifically later. But let's talk a little bit about this sweater first. So I call this sweater the Colour Dash Sweater. And that's because it's got these kind of dashes of colour. So it's a bit of a kind of slightly more modern take on colour work. It has a circular yoke construction, and you can see the colour work goes all the way to like the underarm area. So with this sweater, you will start at the necks, you'll cast them for the neck, and you'll knit it for the top down. It has a few short rows at the back of the neck just to drop the front neck down a little bit to make it a little bit more comfortable around your neck, so you don't feel like it's kind of strangling you. If you want to, you can do more short rows if you want a deeper neck. If you look here, you see this distance here, if we compare that to the front, you can see there's only a couple of rows here, but there's a lot more at the back. So that's where the short rows are. The short rows are across here. The short rows are not difficult, and I have a tutorial which I'll link below. So it's knitted in the round, in stocking stitch. And then you start this colourwork pattern. And the colourwork pattern is basically worked in pearls. So as well as the colour, you also get a little bit of texture, which I'm not sure how easy it is to see. Yes, I think you can see the colour dashes there. So it is just a few stitches that are pearled. There's a few rounds of very relaxing stocking stitch, and then you have the old round where you do some pearl stitches in a different colour. So it's fairly easy colourwork. If you're new to colourwork, this would probably be a good thing to try. It is a little bit different from normal colour work in the fact that you pearl these colour dashes. Now, we went for a quite colourful example with a neutral body. You can do anything really. You could go for a more colourful body and then, or main colour, and then neutral colour dots. You could go, for example, something like, which I would really like pale grey with lots of like purple and pink bright dashes, for example. You could have these dashes all be different colours. Actually, they're not all different colours. I think we use 5 different colours, and then they repeat, and then the two top ones repeat again. So they're not all different colours. You could use all different colours. You could use different colour on each round. You could use the same colour for all of them. You could use a self-striping yarn so that the colour kind of changes randomly, a yarn with longer colour repeats. We used Knit by Numbers by John Arbon, which is a DK yarn, and they do 100 gram skeins, and they also do 20 gram mini skeins. So I used a 20 gram mini skein of each of these 5 colours, and they do colour, they do mini skein sets. So I think they do like sets of 5 20 gram skeins. I know they're doing their 4-ply, or they did doing their 4-ply. I forgot to check, but I'm pretty sure they still do. Or you can buy mini skeins in the colours that you want. So you're not tied to any specific colour scheme, really. I think a lot of their mini skein sets probably come in gradient colours. which would be lovely, really nice. Or you could just pick out the mini skeins in the colors that you really like. So there's a lot of different options with this design. You can go as colorful or as neutral as you want to. I think also, for example, like a dark gray for the body and a light gray for the yoke would be really nice. So there's lots of different options here. I've also used the color, the first color around the yoke in the stripes, which is or the neckline in the stripes, which is working garter stitch. And then I used a different color, two different colors for the hem here and two different colors here and the same colors there. So you could obviously do all those in the same color, so they will match, but I use different colors. Going back to the sweater now, when you come to this, you knit in the round, you increase every so often to create this yoke. And then when you get to the underarm, you put your stitches for the sleeves on hold and you knit on the body, or you can put your stitches for the body on hold and knit on the sleeves. If you don't like knitting sleeves, you can do the sleeves first, so you get them out of the way, then do the body, but it's all knitted in the round. So from the underarm down, it's fairly relaxing because you just knit in the round, stocking stitch in the round. So it's fairly quick, it's fairly relaxing. It's a perfect chance to practice continental knitting if you know how to do the continental knit stitch. If not, I do have an online course. Because it's really, really quick. Continental knit stitch in the round is just perfect because it's so quick. Because you're just knitting every round, there's no purling. So if you don't like purling, this would be perfect. The other advantage for knitting a sweater from the top down is that you can try it on. So I would recommend that when you get to close to where you need to split for the sleeves and the body, that you actually try it on. And you might want to block it, take it off the knitting needle, because the knitting needle will be shorter than the circumference. It'll pull things in a bit. But you can either spread it onto two knitting needles, you can put it on a spare piece of waste yarn, or you can also get these like cords. They're like hollow rubbery plastic cords. I've heard them called try-on cords and stitch holder cords. A lot of shops and people are selling them now, and you can slide the stitches onto those, which is fairly easy, and then try your sweater on and then slide them back onto your knitting needle and carry on knitting. Do remember that the sweater may stretch a little bit when you block it, so I would try it on before I split for the yoke. So probably a couple of 2.5-5 centimeters, 1 to 2 inches before I think I'm going to split for the yoke, I would try it on. And if I like the length, then that's fine. I would split for the yoke then. If I wanted a little bit longer, then I would carry on knitting. But it means that you can kind of customize the fit to fit you. And then when you're knitting the body and the sleeves, you can do the same thing. So you can customize the length of the body and the length of the sleeves. So if you want slightly longer body, you can do, slightly shorter body, you can do. It's kind of about hip length on the model. Obviously, I'm not sure how tall the model is, but you can try it on as you go and customize it to fit you quite easily, which is one of the advantages, I think, of top down sweaters, which are easier to try on as you go than bottom up sweaters. So let's talk a little bit more about the yarn. So the yarn is, as I said, Knit by Numbers by John Arbon. They are based in North Devon, which is, they're actually almost a local to me yarn company. Devon is the county next to Cornwall where I live. They're not that far away from me. And I've been a fan of their yarns for a long time, and I've used them for various designs over the years. And I've always really, really liked the Knit by Numbers range. I think that's my favorite range of their yarns. If you see them at any shows, you will see that they have like a wall of yarn that has like different columns or shelves, and it starts with like a really strong color, I think, at the top, and then it gets paler as it gets down to the bottom. And that's how they created Knit by Numbers. They took the like a really saturated color, and then they gradually added more white to it to make it lighter, so you get like a gradient of each color they do. You get like a gradient from like dark to light, and I really, really like that. We didn't do that for this. We picked out various gradients. So some of them are like the strongest colors, some of them are like the paler, slightly paler colors, but they're not all from the same color gradient. And that's why I said that if you pick out one from each of the color gradients, that would look really nice as well. So you get like a full gradient. That would look really lovely. They do it in DK and 4-ply. This is the DK version. I've used their 4-ply for a few things as well. So I am a big fan of their yarn. Let me just give you a few details about the yarn, which I need to refer to the magazine for that. So it is 10% organically farmed Falkland merino wool. So it's merino wool from the Falkland Islands, spun in North Devon as 250 meters per 100 gram. So the 100 gram skein is 250 meters per 100 gram. It's quite a lot for DK. So it's a quite a good value yarn, really, because you do get quite a lot on each skein. And it is mini skeins are 25 grams. Oh, I thought the mini skeins were 20 grams, but so say they're 25 grams. And the mini skeins are 62 meters per 25 gram. I'm really, really happy with this design. I love the yarn. John Arbon do fantastic yarns. There are a lot of the shows around the UK. So if you want to see the yarn in person, you can find them at a lot of shows. You could also say, for example, buy their DK yarn for the body, and then if you have similar yarns in leftovers, you could use that for the little collar dashes. So it would like be quite good for your sash busting. Or if you've bought any of these mini skein clubs or sets that Indidies do in DK, you might be able to use that. Just make sure that it has a similar tension to the main yarn, because you're only using for these colored dots every few rounds. It's not a huge problem if they vary slightly in tension, but you want to swatch and see what they look like to make sure you're happy with it. So let me show you the picture of the model sweater. That's what it looks like on the model. It is quite a designed to be quite a roomy sweater, so it is quite loose, slightly loose fitting. Obviously, if you want something that's a bit more fitted, you might be able to knit a size smaller. What I would do is check your tension to make sure that matches the pattern, and then check all the measurements in the pattern, and then go for the fit that closely matches what you prefer, the kind of fit you prefer. Because you can customize the lengths. If you want to go for a size smaller or bigger for the yoke, you can customize the lengths. So yeah, I'm really happy with the styling. It looks really nice. It's a nice, cozy, warm sweater, perfect for winter. I wish it was my size because I would definitely wear it, but it's not, so I can't wear it. Let me show you a few of the other designs in this issue as well. So that is a really pretty cardigan with like a hard lace pattern that goes all the way up the side and around the back. It looks like, oh yeah, it has a hood. It has a hood as well, so that's really pretty. I would love to knit something like that for myself, but don't know if I'll have time. And then there's this pretty shawl, yellow, which is knitted in debonair squeal four ply by that's designed by Brian Smith. He has had some beautiful shawls in recent issues of the knitting of Knitting Magazine. And then there's another shawl by Bruno Miscelli, this grey one, which is beautiful. That's knitted in fiberspace gleam lace, which is a mix of I think it's merino and it's either merino or blue face Leicester and silk, and it's beautiful. I've used that a lot of times. That sweater is gorgeous. That's by Chloe Elizabeth Birch, and it's chunky yarn with a raglan, and then it has like these slip stitch color work, which is really nice in darker stitch. And a few other cozy designs. Let's see what else is in here. Some more cozy, colorful designs. Quite a colorful issue, this issue. Must be so difficult being the editor of a magazine and decide on like the theme for each issue and the color scheme for each issue. Not a job I envy at all. I imagine that being quite difficult. And then they have these pages, which I really like, where they take one design and then they show it to you in different colorways, and they show you different accessories that you can style with it. Then they got some like home accessories, blanket, some men's stuff. All the magazines seem to be doing more men's stuff. Then there's some kids stuff and autumn home decor things, pumpkins. There's an Ask Sarah Hazel column. There is a provisional cast-ons tutorial, and then we got the patterns at the back, and then it ends with the Pearl About Town column. So really nice issue, and at the back it's got a big one page full page ad for Knitpro's new Mindful collection, which is beautiful. And I did do a review on that 2 weeks ago, I think, which I will link at the end of this video and below this video. So if you are interested in finding out if the new Knitpro Mindful collection is worth it, then take a look at that and see what I thought of it. I do really like the needles, circular needles. I'm less keen on the whole mindful concept. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Please let me know if you've ever knitted a sweater in the round, a top-down sweater. I do teach sweaters, knitting sweaters top-down with stranded colour work like this. I am teaching it at, let me just have a look on my, I have all my workshops pinned up on the wall behind me. I'm teaching it at the Knitting Hotel in Dawlish in Devon on the 22nd of October. Now, the Knitting Hotel hosts weekend workshop retreats. They go from Thursday afternoon, evening to Sunday evening or Monday morning. And some of them, not all of them, but some of them include 1 or 2 days of workshops. They tend to book up quite a long time in advance, but Belinda sometimes gets cancellations, and she also sometimes takes day guests. So if you were thinking you fancy coming just for the workshop, for the top down circular yoke workshop, then contact Belinda of the Knitting Hotel and see if she can fit you in. Also follow her on Instagram, because if she does have any last minute cancellations, she normally puts them on Instagram first, and they normally go really quickly. So that's the only time I'm teaching my top down circular yoke workshop this autumn, but do sign up to my newsletter, keep an eye on my workshop page on my website, because hopefully I might be teaching you somewhere else next year. Okay, so I hope you liked this video. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate your time. Please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Please consider subscribing. It helps me a lot, and I'm really, really grateful. Leave me a comment, and I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.